channel. Okay, cool. This is like my 10th time trying to record this, and I'm really angry. I was in the middle of recording last time, and I think I'm getting sick or like allergies, and so I started dying. And then after I recovered from that, there's something in my contact, or it's getting ready to fall out. I have like astigmatism in my left eye, and my contact will sometimes just like fall out. So it's whatever. So if you are new to my channel, hello. If you've seen my previous video, welcome back. If you have looked at my channel at all, you'll see I actually finally added like channel art and got my page kind of made up. We are progressing slowly but surely. So I'm really excited to see what else comes from this, and I'm really excited. So this week I wanted to talk about forgiveness. Since this is a faith-based channel, I thought maybe that would be a good one to dive into. Also because it talks about it a lot in my last video. If you saw my my testimony video, my story video, whatever you want to call it, that's what it was. Talked about it kind of a lot, didn't even realize it. And maybe I didn't even talk about it, but it was a big part of what happened. So we're just gonna dive in. Also, I figured out what this is. This is, that was on my face. There's a crack through my tempered glass and it covers the camera. So that's really, it's great, honestly. So I'm trying to find like a cheap camera or something. We're getting there and we'll figure it out. But yeah, like I said, this one's gonna be about forgiveness. I prayed about it kind of like the day or two after I made my first video, and I thought that would be a good topic just because this is a faith-based channel. It is a big part of our faith. And I thought it would be a good one to dive into. So, forgiveness is a hard thing to practice. I think it's easier said than done, and I've definitely learned that these last few years. So if you watch my channel, you know I did kind of, in a sense, get bullied out of my youth group. That's what I'm gonna call it. That's kind of what happened. And they just made me feel really unwelcome, so I had to learn how to forgive everyone for that and how to kind of overcome that as I got older. And it was not something that happened overnight. It was not something that was easy for me. And I don't know, I feel kind of bad for saying that, but at the same time, it's like, forgiveness doesn't happen overnight. Unless it's something small, like I can understand that. But for something as major as this was, and in these last few months with the breakup I went through and with losing all my friends, just, some things take longer to forgive than others, and I've learned that. You know, we're going on almost six months now of being broken up, and it's just like I've finally come to the point where I can say that I completely forgive everything that happened in that relationship. Or like even with best friends, I lost a lot of my friends when I moved, and it was hard for me because I was like, you know, these girls said they were my friends and now they won't even talk to me. So for me, it was a lot of praying and asking God to change my view and change my heart on the way I felt, because it was a lot of like, God, this is how I feel, and I don't want to feel like this anymore. I want to be okay. I want to be able to move on. Because when we hold a grudge in our heart, and when we hold on to something like that, one, you tend to miss those people more. I've noticed, like, if I'm mad at someone, I think about it constantly, and then I get upset about the whole thing over again. Like, it's just not fun to deal with. And so there's that, and it rifts your relationship with God, I think, and a little bit anyways. For me, it did. I don't know if it does for you guys. I don't know. Everyone's different. And so for me, it was hard to be like happy and like cheerful and energetic and want to like do things when I was still mad at these people. And so I think prayer is a really big part of that, because if you're praying about what's wrong, you're communicating with God, He will take that away for you. He takes these things that are in our hearts and He can change that, and He can make that into something good. And I've really learned that these last, you know, few months and few years. So there's that point I kind of wanted to make. And then like apologizing and being able to forgive people without, or forgive people who don't apologize, that's a really big thing too, because not everyone you run into is going to be sorry for something that they've done to you. We live in a world, in a society right now, where it's like, it's cool to be mad at people, it's cool to not care, it's cool to like, oh, you hurt me, so I'm gonna hurt you back, or blah blah blah, you know, like we are very conflicted society, we were a very angry society. And so I think that being able to forgive people who aren't sorry shows a really big maturity level in yourself, and it shows that God is with you and that he's working on you. And I think that's so amazing, because that's what I had to do. I had to kind of suck it up and just let everything go. And I struggled with that, because I was like, I don't want these people to think it's okay. I don't want to be the bigger person. Like, they're not even sorry, you know? And just because you forgive somebody doesn't make it okay. It doesn't make what they did okay. It doesn't mean you're accepting it. It means you're moving on from it. It means you're letting it go so that you can live a life and you don't have to hold on to things that are going to keep you back. Because if you don't let something go, you're going to hold on to it, and you're never going to be able to move on from that situation or into different relationships. And I think that's really important. And I think another thing is that just because somebody says they're sorry, one, doesn't mean they mean it, and two, doesn't mean you have to accept it. I don't know, people might look at that differently. That's how I feel about it, because I've had people apologize to me and then keep doing the same thing over again. I'm like, not sure what that means. Because to me, like, when you apologize, I feel like you should change your actions, because you're apologizing for something that hurts somebody. So you should change the way that you're doing things. And so I feel like if someone's apologizing to you and you know in the long run that they're not sorry, or they have apologized 100,000 times and nothing changes and you feel like they don't mean it, tell them you're not accepting it yet. Tell them you forgive them, but you're not accepting their apology if they don't mean it. Because that's not, it's honestly a redundant apology if nothing's gonna change. And that's just how I look at it. Maybe people look at it differently, but that's how I look at it. Another thing is, like, forgiveness isn't gonna happen overnight. So, like, let's say you get in a fight with someone, that's a really big fight, they said some really bad things about you and your family, blah blah blah. You don't have to forgive people overnight. It's not gonna happen. And things, you know, bigger than that, if your family gets killed by a drunk driver or something huge happens, you're not gonna be able to forgive people overnight. Little things, yeah, maybe a breakup or a friend betrays you and you're not friends anymore, anything like that, it's not gonna happen overnight. And I had to learn that too. It takes a lot of time, and it takes a lot of patience, and it takes a lot of growth. And you have to be able to, like, see both sides of the situation, I think. And maybe you don't, but I do. Like I said, this is just me personally, how I feel about things and how I have how I've grown from things and learned. So that's that, honestly. Another thing I wanted to kind of, like, touch base on, just because I talked about it again in my last video, was, like, when you feel alone or you're feeling like you're not understanding God's plan, like, no matter what, he is still there. Like, no matter what you were going through, he still wants you, he still loves you, he still cares about you. And that's what's so, like, awesome, is, like, through this whole thing, like, when I first moved, side note, if you're new to this channel, the Sufis video you've watched, I just moved here about a year ago, moved to Texas. Not gonna open it, but that's a story for later. I got really angry with God, and I really pulled away, because I didn't understand what he was doing. I was mad at 16. I didn't want to start a high school at 16 in the middle of nowhere. I was not happy about it. And, like, because I have a lot of problems making friends, when I do make friends or I do get a boyfriend or whatever the situation may be, I tend to, like, plan my life out with those friends and, like, where I'm at in that moment, instead of, like, talking to God about it and knowing that God has a plan. Yeah, I still know he's there. Yeah, I still know he has a plan. But I tend to, like, try to take matters in my own hands. News tip, it never works. It's never worked before. It's not ever gonna work. It's not gonna work. So I took some Bible notes over, not even notes, they're just like bullet points, things that I learned, over Genesis, when Abraham is told he needs to sacrifice his son as a test for God. And I really think this move was a test from God to see if I would turn away or if I would come back to him. And it went back and forth. It's been rough. But the first kind of bullet point I took was that withhold nothing from God and he will bless you with everything. Or he will bless you. And I feel like when God moved me, it was him showing me that He still controls everything. He still is planning my life out. He still is the God, and He's still in control of that, and it's not me. You know, like, I can do whatever I want. I made myself get really, really hurt in the process. I was really hurt. I was real upset. It's your choice, you know? So, I'm not going to read the second one because it doesn't really tie in. Don't be angry with the Lord, for He has plans we don't understand, but praise Him all the time and you'll be comforted. So, I kind of read these as two bullet points previously, but it's one. So I'm going to break it in half. Don't be angry with the Lord, for He has plans we don't understand. Slap in the face is what that was. especially with this move, I was so angry, y'all. I was like, why are you doing this? What is the point of this? I don't have any friends. I just lost my boyfriend. Don't have a job. I can't drive. What do you want for, like, what do you want from me? I don't know. And I struggle with that because I, like, with my anxiety, I do have anxiety, like, a little bit. I like to plan things out. I like to know my future. I like to know what's going to happen. And every time that I plan something out, I think God laughs at me because He's like, no, honey, that's not, you're wrong. So this one has been a big learning thing for me. And if you see over there, those yellow index cards along my mirror, I put scriptures up there that kind of calm me down. So, you know, like, I don't even know. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. There's Jeremiah. I have Joshua. Proverbs, I think. I have a bunch of them up there that kind of relate to, like, God knows the plans that we have, but we have to trust Him in order to find out what that is, and we have to put our faith into Him and understand that. So when I do get anxious or when I do freak out, that's an idea. I don't know if people like that or not, but if you do, it's definitely not hard. I just found, like, I googled a bunch of them and was like, you know, try to find things that would calm me down in a situation like that, and those work really well. And then the second part is praise him all the time and you will feel comforted or be comforted again. When I do start having a panic attack or I do start feeling anxious, I will play Christian music, and 9 times out of 10 I'll play a song, and it's like, God, because usually when that happens, I'm praying, like, I'm really deep in prayer and I'm really, like, struggling with something. A song will come on. Like, one time this happened with Love and the Outcome, He is with us. You know, I prayed this prayer, I was crying, I was like, God, I can't feel you. What am I supposed to do? And that song came on and it just hit me really hard. So 9 times out of 10, something like that'll happen. It's kind of nice because you're like, oh, it's okay. You can calm down, you know? So that's just something I do. I don't know. People might think that's weird to sit there and cry and praise Jesus in your room, but it's whatever works for you. This says, live your life for the Lord and you will be fulfilled. Yes. And I think this is easier said than done. This is easier said than done. It's easy to say, you know, yeah, I gave my heart to the Lord, I live for the Lord, but we're not listening to Him and we're just kind of doing our own thing. And, you know, I'm not a preacher, I'm not a pastor, I'm not anything. I'm just a girl that has a relationship with God and I felt like sharing that. So this is just kind of my take on everything and what I learned from this chapter. I read a few pages, I didn't read the whole chapter. Whatever. I think that's easier said than done, because it's easier to be like, oh yeah, I love God, and then, you know, go out and just do whatever we want, whether that's go out and go partying and go drinking or whatever. Especially in high school, I hear a lot about all these kids that say they're one thing and then they go out and do another thing, and it's just really like, are you really though, you know? And I'm not even trying to be like judgmental, it's just like, it's something that we as humans do. We're all guilty of it. I'm guilty of it, not gonna lie. It's easier said than done to say, here's my heart, Lord, and then take it back. We're like, just kidding, I need this back for a minute. So this last one I really like too. When you fight being found by God, He fights harder, and I agree with that. When I tend to pull away from God, I have the Bible app, I have the Sprinkle of Jesus app, I follow a lot of, like, religious pages on my Instagram and on my Facebook, and so I'll either see more of those notifications pop up from the Sprinkle of Jesus in my Bible app, or I'll see more posts from the Christian pages that I do follow, and that's just something I've noticed, or I'll feel, like, this feeling in my heart, like, Taylor, you need to read your Bible. Taylor, you need to listen to worship music. Taylor, you need to pray. Taylor, you need to do something. I can feel it, like, in my heart. Like, I need to do something about it. And so, that one's a yes. So, again, these are just my notes that I took. I took these, like, a month ago. Like I said, I filmed this video so many times, and every time I do it, something happens. So, I don't know. Maybe this was wrong. I prayed about it, but maybe it was still the wrong thing to do. Guess we'll see if I like this one or not. No, I'm not even kidding. I did it. Okay, what's today? Today's Friday. I've been filming since Monday. Filmed it Monday, didn't like it. Filmed it Tuesday, didn't like it. Wednesday, didn't film. Thursday, which was yesterday, I filmed for the third time. And ended up sounding weird. It sounded weird. And then I didn't look. It was my camera. Well, okay, my issue is that I don't have a light. So I have to use my window light. Like, this window that I'm sitting in front of takes up a good majority of my wall. But I don't have, like, a light, like a photo light or whatever it's called that, like, YouTubers use to film their videos. And so it looked really bad. And I was like, we're not posting that. So I didn't like that. So I had to redo that. And then I filmed right before this. And I have a little sister that's, like, almost 2 months old. She was screaming. So you heard that, and then my dad started mowing, so you heard that, and then I started coughing really bad, my allergies are getting bad, and I had to stop for like 10 minutes because I cannot breathe, like, you know, my voice was all weird, and then, so I recovered from that, and then I wear contacts, and I think I might have like eyeliner or something stuck to it, or it's drying out or something. Oh, I have astigmatism too, so sometimes my contacts will just like, I'll just blink, and it'll just like, it'll fall out, so... It's not been easy trying to get this loaded, so maybe I'm not supposed to do it. I don't really know, honestly. I thought I knew, but I didn't, and I've said that a lot. I say that a lot. Like, you know, I'll pray about something, and I feel like it's something I should be doing, and then I do it, and it turns out to be so, so wrong. So, we'll see. And I'm trying to, like, this has shorts under it. It's, like, one of those that has shorts in the front, but then it, like, opens, and it looks weird when I sit down. So, I'm trying to fix that. I'm gonna start, oh, yes, last point, I promise, I'm almost done. I'm gonna start linking, or not linking, I'm gonna post my Instagram in the description, just so you guys can follow me on there. I'm probably a lot more active on there than I am on here. 90% of the time, I'll be able to reply to anything you guys say if you feel like DMing me. I wanted to do, like, a prayer request for people. I did one on Facebook because I felt like it was something I needed to do, and I think I got one like, and no one said anything, and I was like, okay, God, what am I supposed to be doing? So, if that's something you guys are interested in, I would be more than happy to pray for people. I love it so much because I feel like I love helping people. Like, I want to go to school to be a nurse, hopefully, in the next year or so, and I love helping people. I love being able to, like, you know, talk to people and really get to know them and help them. So if that is something you are interested in, I will have my Instagram down below. You are more than welcome to DM me, to follow me, to talk to me, whatever you want to do. So I hope this video wasn't as horrible as you thought it was going to be. I hope maybe I made some points that you could relate to, and if not, that's okay too. I'm gonna start trying to post once a week, but with my phone it takes a good 24 hours for video to load, so we'll have to see what happens. I was gonna start posting like Sunday or Monday, just because with church and stuff I might have an idea for something I want to talk about, or go over church notes or do something. I don't really know, but we'll see what happens from here. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next week.